guys, welcome to my YouTube channel where we're always talking about how to enforce purpose in your life, maximizing you, what you do, and cultures around you. I want you to come into the fullness of the understanding of who you are called to be, what you are called to do, so that you can begin influencing communities around you, cultures around you, spaces and places around you. When you walk into the room, you begin to shift the room because you're carrying the countenance of the kingdom. If this is your first time here, hit that subscribe button. Make sure you like this. Leave me a comment. Today, I'm going to be doing a prayer demonstration for you. Now, I love to teach and train by demonstration. I think it's the best way that we learn. We can actually observe people and the way they do. We see this all throughout the scriptures where Jesus gives a word, then he demonstrates what it looks like, and then he says, now go and do it. It's a see one, do one, teach one concept. And so that's what we are doing today. We are going to be praying through the passage in Luke chapter 1, the Song of Mary. Now, if you want more helps on enforcing prayer in your life, get a copy of my book, Enforcing Prayer. Exactly what it's called. It's how to really activate truths in your life by taking a passage of scripture, declaring it, but then also self-reconciling it. So I'm going to be just kind of walking through and demonstrating how I'm going to enforce prayer in my own life. You'll see times when I'm declaring things back, when I'm praising God. This passage is really just more about magnifying the Lord. And so there may not be as many declarations other than things that I'm declaring about God. But we'll see what happens. I don't really plan these out. I just really enter into the presence of the Spirit and just allow the Lord to begin to navigate. So if you have your Bible and you want to follow along, I'm going to be in Luke chapter 1, starting in verse 46. And I'm going to be reading through verse 55, wherever the Lord takes us. And we're going to just enter into the presence of the Lord. So, Father, we just thank you right now in Jesus' name. We just receive your presence. We thank you that your presence is hovering upon us. We thank you, Lord, that you never leave us. You never forsake us. That's what your word promises in Hebrews. And so, God, we just receive that truth right now in the name of Jesus. And we declare, God, that you have always been with us. You are with us right now, and you will be with us every moment of our life. That even if we were to try to shake free from your presence, God, we would not be able to shake loose because you will never leave us. So, Father, I thank you for your word in Jesus' name. My soul magnifies the Lord. I'm in verse 47. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit has rejoiced in God, my Savior. God, I declare that my soul magnifies you, that my soul is fat with you, the fullness of my mind, the fullness of my heart. God, every choice that I make, come on, that's your soul, your mind, your will, and your emotions. God, every part of me, my personality, not just my spirit, but God, my soul is going to magnify you. Come on, when we magnify something, we make it bigger, right? When I use a magnifying glass, I'm making something bigger. And so, God, I thank you that my soul is bigoting you. Come on, is magnifying you in Jesus' name. And my spirit has rejoiced in God, my Savior. And so, Father, I thank you that not just my soul magnifies you, but my spirit is rejoicing in you. And that is not a part in my life, God, that is not aware of you. God, just illuminating you and rejoicing in your presence. For you have regarded the lowly state of your maidservant. God, I thank you, Lord, that you found me where I was at, that you picked me up out of the miry clay. God, and you set my feet upon the rock, that you pulled me up out of darkness and you brought me into the kingdom of light. God, and I thank you, Lord, that from here on forth, God, everybody will call me blessed, God, that your holy angels call me blessed, that you call me blessed, because I've been brought under the blessings of the kingdom, the inheritance of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, your word says, for he who is mighty has done great things for me. And holy is his name. Come on. Somebody needs to declare that right now. God, you are mighty and you have done great things for me. God, I repent of not, God, just declaring all the great things that you've done for me. Holy is your name. God, I repent, God, of not acknowledging all the ways you have moved in my life, for not acknowledging you when I have breath in my lungs, not acknowledging every beat of my heart. God, it's because you sustain my life. You have done great things in my life, and I declare you are mighty. Come on, somebody declare that. God, you are mighty. You are mighty. Holy, holy, holy is your name. Your mercy is on those who fear you. And so, God, I just receive, God, your mercy, God, even as I come into a reverence and awe, a fear of you as the God of all gods, the King of all kings, the God of all creation, the God who holds my life in the palm of his hand. I thank you, Lord, and I receive, God, the mercy that is poured out upon me even today. I thank you for your grace. I thank you for your mercy. God, I thank you that you pour out your love upon me from generation to generation. I thank you, Lord, I can speak that over generations to come. God, that your mercy is upon my children. Your mercy is upon my children's children. Your mercy is upon their children for many generations to come. God, I thank you that your mercy is upon them. You have shown your strength with your great arm, and you have scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. God, I thank you, Lord, that you have shown great strength, God. And that you bring, God, you scatter people, God, whose imaginations are not in line with your kingdom. And so, God, come on, I'm just going to receive that right now. I thank you, Lord, that even when people come to me with their false imaginations, that you scatter them away from me. And God, I thank you that your strength is within me and that you have showed me your strength, that you are greater than any problem that I can come into, God. I just declare that your strength is the one true strength, that your imagination is the one true imagination, that the revelations of the kingdom are what illuminate the imaginations of my heart and of my mind. And I reject, I rebuke, God, any other imagination in Jesus' name. It goes on and it says, remember, this is Mary's song that she's singing. He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted the lowly. God, you are an inside out God. And what the world says should be exalted, God, there is no exaltation for them in the kingdom. But God, on the flip side, the things that the world would call lowly, you lift up. I'm reminded that you say in James that if we were to humble ourselves before the Lord, that you will lift us up. And so, God, I receive the exaltation of the kingdom and the kingdom alone. God, I look not for the exaltation of the world, but I look only, God, for the affirmation of my one true God. I thank you, it is by your love, God, that you have anointed me far above all of my companions. I receive the anointing oil, God, that says you exalt your children upon high, that you bring up, God, what the world would otherwise dismiss. Come on, when all the world missed out on David, God, you found David being faithful out in the field. When all the world missed out on the maidservant, Hagar, you found Hagar when she was in the wilderness, God. When all the world missed out on Gideon, the smallest man of the weakest clan who was hiding in a cave, God, you found him. And so I thank you, God, that you found me. God, you found me, a stay-at-home mom, staying in my home, doing homeschooling my kids, cleaning poop off of little bottoms and doing laundry and cooking and just doing what you've asked me to do. God, you found me. You found me. You spoke to me. I thank you for the intimacy that I have with you in the places that you have exalted what seemed like lowly places in my life. That I can think, come on, I can think of places in my life, God, when I seemed the most down, I seemed the most depressed, I seemed the most dark, but God, you found me in those places and you lifted me up. Come on, I'm reminded that he is, the more the rain came down, the more the ark went up. Come on, it was the waters and the flood, the rain, it was the storm that rose up the work of God, that rose up the ark. And so God, we thank you, Lord, that you exalt things that the world would call lowly, that you have filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. God, I just receive the good things of the kingdom. God, I thank you. I just break off the mentality of what the world would say is rich, what the world would say is gonna fill me, what the world would say is food to my soul. I break off that thought because your word says that you fill me with good things. God, even as I have come to you hungry, even as I've come to you empty, when I've come to you lonely, when I've come to you angry, come on, whatever that lowly place is for you, God, I come to you and I ask you to fill it with the good things of the kingdom. Come on, this is where you get to come before the Lord and say, God, I come to you empty. God, I come to you lonely. God, I come to you, God, feeling purposeless. Whatever it is, I come to you, Lord, feeling worthless, unseen, feeling isolated, feeling angry, feeling depressed. I come to you in my addiction. Christian, God, and I am looking, God, I am needing, I am hungry for the good things of the kingdom, God. I'm receiving the satisfaction that only you can bring, the company of the kingdom, the presence of God, the relief of my depression, God, whatever it is, come on, begin to declare it in your life. And he has sent away the things in my life that appeared to be rich. He has sent those things away from me and said, those things will come to nothing in your life. Come on, we just receive that right now in the name of Jesus. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy. And he has spoke to our fathers, to Abraham and his seed forever. So God, I thank you that you are a God of your promise, and that everything you have spoken, every word that you have said, God, that you have a remembrance, and that you bring unto us the remembrance of your word, the remembrance of your covenant, the remembrance of our salvation, the remembrance of Jesus Christ, our Savior, the remembrance of the Redeemer who picked us up, plucked us up out of our own selfish ways and brought us into the fulfillment of the kingdom. We thank you, Lord, that you are bringing into our mind right now a remembrance of what a good and a mighty Father you are. And I thank you, Lord, for your word. I thank you that it is life. I thank you that we get to declare the goodness of God, that we get to magnify the Lord, that our soul gets to, God, make you bigger and make you better, that gets to worship you and praise you and just speak the goodness of our God on a daily basis. God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the healing that you bring into our lives. We thank you, Lord, for the richness that you bring into our space, into our place. We thank you for your company. We thank you for your presence. We thank you, Lord, that even if we were to try to escape you, we could not escape you. We thank you, Lord, that if we look to the right, we would find you. If we look to the left, we would find you. Come on, now we're just praising and worshiping God. I'm not asking him for anything. I'm not interested in asking him for anything. I'm just sitting here receiving all that he has poured out upon me. God, I just receive your goodness. I receive your love. I receive your grace. I receive your confidence, your authority, your power. God, I thank you that you've given me strength to stand upon the heights, that I can bend a bow of bronze. God, I receive the truth of who you are and the truth of who I am, who you've called me to be, the path that you have placed me on. I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. All right, now this is just how we pray. I'm allowing the scriptures to begin to just navigate this conversation with the Lord as I'm declaring these things as true in my life. All right, you guys, I'm going to keep praying. I feel the presence of the Lord in me, on me, all around me in this space. So I'm going to go ahead and end this video, but I want you, I'm praying that this video for you is just a beginning of a long conversation, a prayer time, an interaction between you and the Holy Spirit that is intimate. I bless you in the name of Jesus. Remember, enforcing purpose, it starts with you.